Sorry about that. Okay, it's New Year's Eve, 31st. Got my first vodka and Coke. It's my little tipple. Aristol Lime. It's only 20% alcohol, but it's really nice drink, especially in the summer. I'm having one there. So, Happy New Year when it comes. I know nobody's going to be watching this tonight over the next few days because everybody will be partying or going to see relatives, but Happy New Year to everybody and thank you for subscribing. We're up to 750 now, so I'm very pleased. Thank you very much indeed. Anyway, yeah, subject at hand, Cuba. So, yeah, my wife and I have been talking about going to Cuba now for about 2 years, and we were going to go and stay there for 2 weeks. We're going to have a week in Havana, in the city, and then a week in a place called Valaderos, I think it's called, which is more like a kind of resort, which wouldn't have been my idea of fun, because I'm not really big at sitting in the sun and on deck chairs, you know, reading. I mean, you can only read so many car magazines. Anyway, I don't mind getting the suntan, but I spent 30 years in the oil business in a lot of hot countries all over the world, especially a lot in the Middle East, and you know, work having to work in the sun, so I avoid it like the plague. Anyway, that being said, Cuba. So we went on a cruise, and it was called, the name of the company was MSC. It's an Italian group, and the ship we were on was called MSC Armonia. And like I said, it's an Italian ship, so we thought, and it was a couple of months basically before the winter was coming on. About 2 months before the trip, so my wife saw it, been really pushed, really advertised very heavily in Austria and Germany, and it was the only ship that was going doing this Cuba. There was other ships coming into Cuba, but this was doing mainly from Cuba, back to Cuba and back out again. So that's why we took it, because we thought, well, you know, for the price of the cruise, we get to see a few other countries, Jamaica and Cayman and so on and so forth, Mexico. And if we like any of these places, we can always go back and have a holiday there. So we thought, oh, you know, it's a good fact-finding trip. And as it's turned out, it has been very much a fact-finding mission. We've learned a lot of things, a lot of things we wouldn't do again, a lot of things we would do. The weather was fabulous, I have to say. We had some tropical showers, but most of them while we were on the boat or we were sailing. But apart from that, the weather was brilliant. It was 28, 30 most of the time. The downside of the trip was my wife was ill on this boat. Unfortunately, the food on this ship was very poor. It was poor standard. We paid the top end, so we'd gone for a suite with a cabin, a cabin with a suite, but also a balcony. So we had a balcony because we're smokers and we did smoke outside. You're not supposed to, but everybody seemed to be doing it. Anyway, bottom line was the cabin was great. The crew. All the people that were doing the serving were really, really nice. A lot of people from, most of them were third world countries, but they were really nice people, really nice. Anyway, that side of it was great. The only downside to the boat was two things to the ship was, one was the first week we went was before Christmas, and there was quite a few people on, but you could lay on the deck or you could lay on the lounges and so on. It wasn't wall-to-wall people. The second week from over Christmas and New Year, they'd oversold it. They'd sold it so cheap to fill the boat, because obviously it costs the same thing. It's like planes with asses on seats. So they'd oversold it, and it was mobbed. It was to capacity, and on the decks of the days when we were cruising, it was just wall to wall people. It was like a bloody seal colony. You know, there was just bodies everywhere. But fortunately, there was another deck that we had to pay extra for, but we did it because you couldn't sit otherwise or have a smoke or whatever. Anyway, that being said, that was the one downside. And the other downside was the food. The food was absolutely atrocious. It was tasteless. It was cooked in the lowest grade oil or whatever they could find, or maybe it had been used so many times. I'm sure the hygiene wasn't great. Anyway, bottom line was is, after the second day, after the first night we'd eaten there, the next day we were both feeling a bit stodgy, and I had a bad stomach and I had the runs. And we went on an excursion, and we were in a boat going up this channel in Belize City, and I desperately needed the toilet. So it was like that for the rest of the trip. I was never sick or anything, but not far from it. But on the 23rd, my wife was very sick. And I'm going to show you a little clip of a video where we were in Montego Bay, and I explain what happened, and this didn't put any bias on Cuba. This was nothing to do with Cuba. This was the boat issue. But I'll show you the little video. But just quickly before I show you the video to finish off, the thing with Cuba is they have a deal there where the tourists have to have cooks, which is €1 to one cook. And the locals have their own, which is pesos. And I don't know if it's 50 or 100 to 1 or 200 to 1. I mean, they're saying that they're earning $25 to $30 a month. And if that's the case, the chip money they were charging us, they have to be earning, the exchange rate must be 200 or 2,000 to 1, or 200 to 1 at least, to make it even plausible. But this is what they're saying. Cuba's a very interesting place. It's got some beautiful buildings, but it's so badly run down. You know, it's like Aleppo on a good day. It really, I mean, the buildings are just destroyed. They're falling apart from underneath them. The balconies are falling. There's constant grating everywhere. You have to be careful where you step. And we went down a lot of the back streets. We wanted to look and see how people were living. And we always believed that Cuba would be very vibrant and have a lot of soul to it. And, you know, the people there, there is this going on. And you'll see it on documentaries and you'll see it on YouTube. But it's done for the tourists. As soon as a bunch of tourists are there, they'll start doing something, you know, to get money or whatever it is. But the average Cuban is not having a good life. It's and the fact that Cuba Castro had died a week before we went, it wasn't because of that. People weren't sad by any means. And I'm fairly sure that they're quite glad that the regime might come to an end. So this idea that Cuba's going to be spoiled is horseshit. Really, you couldn't spoil it. It's so far down and it's so decaying that you couldn't spoil it, no matter what happened. It can only improve. And the same thing with the cars. You know, this, I thought most of these cars would all be nicely done up because they use them for taxis. You're lucky if it's 10%. None of them have anything original on them. But that's not their fault. They were embargoed for 50 years. But most of them are scrap and they're not filled with even Bondo or filler. They've got cement in them, concrete. Yeah, you know, unbelievable. Anyway, but that's either in there. If you want to go to Cuba, for sure, go and have a look. We would have gone, but I can tell you there are a lot of, you really want to look into the other sides of it, and actually staying in Havana in a hotel, I would really not recommend. Anyway, I'll show you this little video, and this is what happened on Christmas Eve. So this is the sorry saga of what happened. It was, I'll put this on so you can see it, hopefully. Put my glasses on. There we go. So this is it here. I'll try and do it off the video because I can't, as you know, I can't do the. So this is the boat on a day in.
It's the 24th of December. We're in Montego Bay in Jamaica, as you can see. Still on board this MSC Amoria ship. It's an Italian boat ship. And there's another one there from, I'm not sure what country that one's from. Bristol. Something or other. This is the top deck for passengers with balconies and suites. And then they have another deck down here. Now, there's nobody on board the ship hardly at the moment because we're in dock in Montego Bay. But this place down here where this water fountains is terrible. It's like a seal colony when we're at sea. You cannot move. Every part of this deck has got people on it. That's why we come up on this top balcony. You have to pay for it, obviously, but it's worth it because it's a lot nicer. But the bad news is, it's 24th of December, so it's Christmas Eve, and my wife, after a meal in one of their restaurants last night, was violently sick and had some other problems, diarrhea. And she was in the hospital this morning on the ship under the ship's doctor, and had to have an infusion. So she's now in the cabin and trying to sleep. And tomorrow we're off to the Cayman Islands, and I just hope that things get better. So yeah, just a little report on what's going on. So I'm sat here on my own. I've actually been on the ground in Jamaica and bought a couple of t-shirts, and that's a 20-minute visit to Jamaica for Christmas Eve. Anyway, talk to you when I get back to Austria, and this is me signing off. So, see what happens tomorrow. Bye for now. Take care. Bye.
So, take care and have a good New Year. Bye for now.